Good morning, everyone. It is so great to have you join with us again this morning. And good morning, Hamilton. How are you doing today? Are you good? Thumbs up? Yep, it's good to have you with us. And it's good to have all of you with us today. So we've got lots in store for you this morning. We've got the God Spot. We have got a story. We have got Professor Bonkers joining with us again. And we've got a brand new song as well. So we're going to head straight into the God Spot and find out what you guys have been up to this week.
One time I got, my finger was bleeding, and then when I looked back, it was sealed up.
Okay, Hamilton, should we see if anybody has sent anything into us this week? Thank you. You do that so well, by the way, Hamilton. Right, so we've had Dylan. Yes, Dylan has been reading Bible verses and standing on God's promises, and he has sent this lovely picture of a rainbow, which really reminds us of God's promises, doesn't it? And Dylan, it looks like you've had a very cool haircut recently. So don't forget, everybody, that you can send in anything you've been doing. It could be a craft, a picture, a Bible verse, something you just want to tell us. You can send it to our vkids@vintagechurchla.com email address, and then we can see what you guys have all been up to. So it is time for our story now, and this story is about how Jesus is a friend to children, and the story is told in three different books of the Bible, in Matthew, Mark, and in Luke, which are all the Gospels, which is in the New Testament. So all those different people wrote down this story after it had happened. So maybe you can have a look in your Bibles at home and see if you can find it. So in this story, Jesus' friends were arguing. It starts with an argument. I don't know if you've ever argued with your friends or your brothers or your sisters. I know that I definitely have. But in this argument, Jesus' friends were saying to each other, who's the best helper in God's kingdom? And one of them said, I am. And then one of the others said, no, I am. And the thing was that they thought that they had to do something extra special to make Jesus like them the best. But they'd actually forgotten something that God had been teaching them all along. Which is that it doesn't matter how clever you are, how kind you are, how good your grades are at school, what you look like, where you're from, God's love is a gift. And like with so many gifts, his love is free. And you can just reach out and take it. And here's the thing, when Jesus was talking to all these people who were arguing, a lot of children came, but the people saw the children and they thought, no, Jesus doesn't have time for these children. They said to the children, go away. There's not time for you. He can't see you. No, you're not important enough. But when Jesus saw what had been happening, he said to the people, no, move to the side. Let the children come to me. Because you see, Jesus loved these children and the children loved Jesus, and they knew that they didn't have to do anything extra special to make him love them anymore. So Jesus said to the people, have hearts like these children. They are so important in my kingdom. Because of course, first of all, we are all children of God. Hello everyone, Professor IB Bonkers here, and I've got my good friend Hamilton helping me along. It is great to see you all again this morning, isn't it? Right, what a great story about how Jesus loved the children, because the thing is, we're all children of God, aren't we? Brilliant! And the thing is, Jesus loved all people, didn't he? He loved the thieves. He loved the tax collectors. He loved the sick people. He loved the poor people. He loved the children. He loved people who were the same as him. He loved people who were different from him. He loved everybody. And the thing is that his love is the same today as it was back then and forever for everybody, which is great news, isn't it? Now, I've got a question for you. Have you ever been asked to give a reason for something and you've just said, just because? I know I have as well, yeah. So the thing is that God, he doesn't say he loves us just because. He doesn't say he loves us just because we're kind or helpful or getting good grades, because that would mean if we stopped being kind or helpful or getting good grades, that he wouldn't love us anymore. He loves us because he loves us. He loves us just because we're all God's children, aren't we? Brilliant. It's good news, isn't it, Hamilton? Yeah. So, here's the thing. We can't do anything to make him love us anymore. We can't do anything to make him love us any less. And in the Bible, it tells us to love others as he has loved us. Amazing. So I was thinking, do you know what this is? Do you know what this is, Hamilton? Yeah, it's a measure, exactly. It's a measuring cup. You might measure your Brussels sprouts to put in your cookies. No, you don't put Brussels sprouts in cookies, do we? I know, I was just being silly. You might fill that up with chocolate chips or something, I would. But can we measure the love of God in this? No, we can't. What about this? A measure, tape measure. Do you think we can measure the love of God in with this? No, I don't think so either, Hamilton. You're absolutely right. What about this? This is a watch. Nice watch here. I've borrowed from Hamilton. Thanks, Hamilton. Can we measure how long God's going to love us with our watch? No, we can't. Exactly. We can't measure because he loves us so much. And he tells us to love others as well because he has loved us first. Amazing. So I was going to do, what I've got here is I've got a jar and it says our love. So this is, imagine that's us, our love there. And imagine that this is someone in your life. Someone you know, someone you don't know. Could be anybody. And this sponge is, what we're going to do is we're going to soak in. We've got some love in there. Can you see? We've got some of it. We're soaking it up, yeah. And then we can pour that love into the people we know. Not that much, is there? There's a bit of our love, so we can dip it in again. And then we can pour that love, oops, got a bit on the table, never mind, into the people that we know. And yeah, there is a bit of love, isn't there? We've got just our love. But what if we had the love of God in our hearts? What would that be like? How much could we spill over into other people, Hamilton? What do you think? Oh, it's a bit heavy. I've got something down here. Look, it's God's love, Hamilton. Look at that. God's love. So let's move our love out of the way and see how we get on with God's love. So if we've got love of God in our hearts, we can pour so much more into all the people around us, can't we? We can fill them all the way up. We can fill them up with God's love, can't we? Because in the Bible, it says, love others as I have loved you. And God loves us no matter what we've done. He knows exactly what we've done, but he still loves us, doesn't he, Hamilton? No matter who we are. So we can love other people no matter who they are. We can fill them all the way up with all the love of God that's filling us up. Brilliant. It's great news, isn't it, Hamilton? High five. Thanks for joining us. See you later.
Well, our memory verse today really fits with that experiment that you just saw there. So it's all about loving others because Jesus has loved us as well. So it's from the book of John, and it's from John 15, verse 12. Now that's in the New Testament. So see if you can find it in your Bible at home. And it's all about how we can love others as Jesus has loved us. So Fiona's going to read it for us now. Thank you, Fiona.
Love others as I have loved you. John 15, verse 12. So it's time for our worship now. And I don't know if you remember last week we learned about the walls of Jericho and how when there was a great shout, all the walls came tumbling down. And today our worship song is about that. It's about how God can bring down the walls and how powerful worship is. And worshiping when things are going well, worshiping when things are difficult as well, can be really powerful. So it's a new song, so have a look at the actions, and we've got some really fun ones. We've got one where you can pretend to be a superhero, and we've got one where we're bringing the walls down. So have a look, and let's everybody stand up and worship together.
Of the enemy, we're turning up the anthem that set us free. Your mighty name will ever be the soundtrack of our victory. We're lifting up your praise like a battle cry. The thunder of your name breaks apart the night. Your matchless grace will ever be the soundtrack of our victory. Onward! is crumbling, is tumbling down. Every wall is tumbling down at your name, Jesus.
It has been so great to have you join with us again for another VKIDS Sunday. And don't forget that you can check out all of our fun activities online at vintagechurchla.com/VKIDS to do all of our curriculum there in the week. And we also, on Wednesday at 10 o'clock, we have our Godspot and Praise Party, which is just a great time to hang out and then to do our worship with all of the actions and dance moves as well. So get your parents to check out their emails for the links to that as well. And for now, it's goodbye from me and Hamilton, and we'll see you next week. Bye!